Hello and welcome back to GTA 2. And when we last left off, we completed all the missions from the Yakuza faction in downtown, and some of them turned out to be pretty devious by all considerations, right? And today, of course, it leaves the Zaibatsu Corporation, but we're starting out with zero reputation, so we have to get on their good graces somehow. I guess we figure out what we can do here, shall we not? So let's just continue from our save game and see what we can accomplish today. Yeah, without our body armor, of course. Okay, otherwise, I think they do care about the lunatics, if I'm not misremembering, yes? And I suppose we could try the last lunatic mission again if we wanted to. Alright, well, I do have some sort of idea what we could be trying first, but for now we need some transportation. So this will do. Yeah, remember that fire truck over there with the flamethrower? I think it's actually a kill frenzy. That could be funny. Aber also some areas upstairs we could investigate if we wanted to. Fast reload, yes. I don't think it's really applicable to a flamethrower. Yeah, we're down to 3 lives, right? As a reminder, so we cannot afford to die too often. But that's the problem. Yeah, I think it was next to the compound, some plates, which is rather convenient if you ask my opinion. And since we're here, we can also pick up some body armor. Yeah, maybe also some machine gun ammo, since we keep losing our weapons for whatever reason. I wonder why. Alright, I think carjackers don't target empty cars, in case you're wondering about that. Yeah, body armor and some machine gun ammo, I think it's fine. Do we really want to try the last mission again? I'm not quite sure, man. We already failed 3 attempts. And we want to, of course, work for Zaibatsu, not oppose them. Ah, but I'm not so sure about that. Maybe we give it one more try. Maybe. Just for completion's sake, I suppose. Oh, maybe. Okay, I suppose we can try that. Maybe. If it doesn't work well.
Machine gun.
Yeah, the Yakuza section was actually pretty easy by comparison. Because, well, at the moment we have full reputation, so they won't actually be shooting back. Gaming the reputation system in this game makes some missions a lot easier, even just possible for that matter. Because sometimes it's just indeed plain impossible without doing that. Especially later on. Okay, all we need now is a Z-type somewhere. It really shouldn't be so difficult, but sometimes the spawn rate is a little bit strange, as you've noticed. Eventually we're going to get one, yes? Pretty please. Okay, this shall work, I think. So we make our hasty retreat. Yes, hasty retreat, I said, thank you very much. Please stop blasting my car, thank you very much. Well, your car, but my points do stand. So this time around, we don't need any frontal assault guns on our car, thank for them. This could almost be a surgical strike against the Yakuza faction. Like a bunch of backstabbers that we are at the moment. But the Zaibatsu portion will be a little bit more difficult, of course. Maybe we have to retreat and get a second Yakuza car. It could be necessary, we'll see about that. Yeah, happy hunting. If no one is actually aggressive towards us, there's not much of a hunt here. Yeah, ha ha ha, we only lose one pip of reputation each. Could be worse, frankly. Even the carjacker is scared, rightfully so. Well, Podesta is a pretty quick to evade you in this title. Unlike the first game, of course. Yeah, broken bones. Probably more than just broken bones, incidentally, and it can actually be revived, but this apparently isn't part of the mission objective, and no one cares, I guess. Well, whatever. Yes, yes, I know it's confusing around here with the pointers and the districts and everything. There we go. Okay. Oh, this one right here, incidentally. So we could actually still take red missions from the Yakuza if we wanted to, so there's that. Okay, so I think this time around we try to kill as many targets as possible and then retreat and get a different car, I suppose, maybe. It's not like money is a problem any longer. Yeah, two people in a compound. Maybe we start with this, because they're apparently able to escape, for whatever reason. Strange how it works. There was an isolated target to the north someplace too. But if you fail this mission yet again, I don't think I will bother once more. Don't drive into the side alleys, it's a death trap. Especially because you have to do everything at speed. Yeah, it's advanced of products. So, they can actually retreat and escape. I'm not quite sure how and why, but apparently it's possible. I'm not quite sure what the parameters for this are. Oh, this radio station is annoying. Okay, so we got him. Now it's down to the guy in the middle of the compound. Okay, get out of the way, you goddamn idiots. Thank you. Uses machine guns. Okay, there we go, the final job from the loonies. Excellent, so now we need to shoot some loonies indeed, and we start with the truck, or maybe just expand the remaining 10 bullets of this machine gun. Could also be a good idea, frankly. But for now we need to make a hasty retreat, ideally. Oh, wasn't that fancy? So we can do it after all. Maybe it's a good idea to save the game here, but I don't think it's really necessary. Maybe an intermediate save just in case the game crashes or whatnot, can certainly happen. Speaking of which, the church is right around the corner, right, isn't it? I think. Yeah, we just have to follow the arrow, I guess. Yeah, there we go. But I hope it doesn't despawn our car, but if we are really close, it really shouldn't happen. Yeah, I'm not quite sure, the game has never crashed on me before in recent memory, so it should be fine, but who knows. We finally completed that mission, yes. Finally, after 4 attempts. Then again, the reputation did work out for us, as you can tell evidently, so we took less damage overall. And the Yakuza, of course, is armored. So, there's that. Yeah, there we go, see how quickly we lose reputation. And now of course we're a little bit of a bad shape. There we go, accident. Okay, where was that fire tractor? I don't think it was too far away, but I don't remember exactly where it was. Not the trailer. If our multiplier, there shouldn't be much of a worry to meet the Cure Frenzy. I think that's scared, yes. Was it over here? Could be. Okay, get off the Jeffrey card, could be useful. I'm not sure where it was, I kind of forgot, I'm sorry. Maybe you can still find it, but for now we need an undamaged car ideally. But we certainly can take some jobs from the Zappers for now. The flamethrower could be funny though. This game is very baggy. So why wouldn't we? If you can find it, of course. There, no, it's a generic car. Well, if you cannot find it, oh well, I suppose. But it was certainly in Looney territory over here someplace. I do remember that. It is not the largest district in the world. Certainly wasn't big here, I think. People with guns aren't scared by your terrible driving. Well, whatever, I cannot find it, so we're doing some Zebatu jobs now. I think it's two from the green telephone, two from the yellow telephone, maybe four, and two red jobs, right? Something like that. Seems to be the same setup for every single faction in this game, at least in this district. So it gives, I guess. Okay, this place also has only a handful of gates into the compound to trap you inside. That's going to be important later, I'm sure. Well, goodbye, loonies. Maybe not. Alright, so not through here, of course. Watch where you're walking, sir. Not my fault. Taxi maybe not the best ride for the job, but I guess it works. Yeah, they would jump over your car, thankfully. But that saves a lot. That's vulnerable in this game. Where's the stupid telephone, man? The Batsu territory is a bit of a confusing mess sometimes, and most sectors even. Of course, I don't have a map or anything. Oh, let me guess, it's inside the compound someplace. Yeah, probably right. Ugh. Yeah, someone was blasting someplace. Yeah, there we go. Alrighty. Bombs in your pants, mate. Okay. That type of bomb, I'm sure. Pretty fancy, right? But of course, that bats all the money in the world. Alright, so we're dealing with the cops again. They seem to be the minor player in this universe, unless we antagonize them too badly and they call in the SWAT teams, the FBI, and later on the army. Yeah, yeah. Okay. But sure, we can get some money on the side. If he doesn't have a destination, I guess we take it. Taxi missions wouldn't really be a thing until GTA 3, while the ambulance and vigilante missions too. Okay, in here. Okay, end of the line for you. Yeah, well, shady, he is certainly shady, yes. Train station, aber dem. Try to keep the car intact because the cop car isn't the sturdiest one around. Certainly is not. Ich sitze fast mit ohne wieder in Straight Line. Ich war horn sort of. It's more like a siren. Ja, jetzt die Sabatsu und ein Car-Crusher. Ja, ich finde, das ist die Hospital. Die sind das District. Ich war now the care, apparently. Bound to Earth. Ich kenne wie die Blend-In in a Cop Car. It doesn't work, unfortunately. I'm not quite sure where it is, because I don't have a paper map. Could be very useful for this game. Turned out to be invaluable. Yeah, for GTA 1 in London, respectively. Okay, here apparently. Is this one open to the public, or is it just for Sabatsu jobs? I'm not sure. Yeah, we locked the car doors, I think, maybe. Is that an issue in the police cruiser anyhow? Ja. Okay. I think they do give us a cop bribe. Just to confirm my memory. I think they do give us a cop bribe. If we crash a police car. Of course, they don't need one at the moment, but it could be useful. Cops don't usually spawn in these crushers, in these scrap yards. Yeah, there we go. Indeed, it's a cop bribe. That's what I remembered. Fucking pickpockets. They will follow you everywhere. Even during story missions. Oh, a Benson. No. But there's a Benson in the game, certainly. But I take it. There aren't many fast cars in downtown. Really. And of course, we are listening to the Krishna radio station for whatever reason. Why would we punish ourselves like that? Elevation does make a difference when it comes to the camera zoom level. It will be a problem in the residential sector primarily. I think it's only two green missions to get you started. We can't have that, of course. That could be on a timer, but good thing with the first car. Now just down to good driving. That's debatable. Oh, we can get around here like that, I guess. can we use our car, or does it have to be a Z-type? I mean, it's certainly fast in a straight line, but otherwise, it's not that impressive and very, very tail happy. Almost impossible to control sometimes. Okay, and here, where is the door? Alright, okay. We can maybe back into the courtyard, but I don't think that's the way to go. Maybe it is. But it doesn't give us a distance meter, so I have to hope for the best. Okay, I'm collecting the package apparently. Rebellets. Okay, this is our first type mission, at least the officially type mission. There was of course some timers involved previously, but it was not stated. Yeah, we don't want the cops on our ass, right? Do we now? Although I suppose it wouldn't be the matter that much. Okay, here have your dodge. Whatever. Snuff. Yeah, then the blow. TikTok was the clock, yes. I don't really like to deal in drugs. I mean, criminal dealings are fine and all, but drugs is usually one step too far. Oh, this is very generously timed, of course, still, since the baby mission. Yeah, but I do believe a certain real-life crime organizations refused to deal in drugs right until the 1980s or something like that. Then it just became too tempting in terms of money earned, return of investment and everything. Yeah, I think in 1980s, that's when the drug epidemic really spiraled out of control, yes. Man, why would you override this, you idiot? I guess he is voting for attention. Okay. So, but we have to kill a couple more loonies, otherwise we cannot take any yellow missions. Wow, that should be kinda funny to do. Don't think I want to invest at 25,000. I guess we just run over some dudes. Yeah, it's not easy to earn favors with Zabatsu. At least sometimes. Yeah, remember when we were best buddies? That was a long time ago, wasn't it? And these are unarmed anyway, so... But how many mental patients were there around, huh? In this asylum of theirs. I think all the gangs only pack pistols in the first chapter of the game. So there's no need to worry too much. Yeah, just have a little bit of a safety margin. But running them over doesn't deal as much of a reputation damage compared to shooting them. Yeah, okay, that should be plenty, I think. It didn't even shoot up our car, imagine that. A little bit, I suppose, but we can maybe put some Bondo over the bullet holes. Yeah, insanity is guaranteed in this universe and little else. So there's the crusher, but there's the telephone. Where the heck is that? Over there someplace? Are we exiting this by footbridge? Yeah, I guess it's the Zabatsu way of doing things. Maybe we find some suitable transportation over there. Otherwise we have to hope this thing doesn't despawn. But surely this route exits here somehow, right? Maybe? Maybe not. Well, could be. I'm not sure. At least I don't see any road access, and it seems to be the map edge. Okay, well, oh, there's actually a road leading to here. That's what I figured. Once again, it would be nice to have a paper map for our playthrough, but of course I don't have that thing. Machine gun. Use, whatever that is. Okay, so apparently it's a startup gang in this town, and we cannot have that. That's why we don't mess with Zabatsu. We really shouldn't. There we go, there should be plenty. I think they show up in every single district, yes? Okay, let's just try to map out the area a tiny bit, in case there's a type mission, and there's a spray and paint back here. Well, isn't that convenient? Come on, mister, move it. I guess what we're going to do is to crush them, you know, stealing a Z-car as a bait, something like that. I think that would be right in line with Mr. Belch. Yeah, of course it doesn't. All the radio stations in this game are just as waggy as the game itself. Love it. Konami FM. Ja, ja. There we go. Somewhere. If I don't crash into this, whatever it may be. Okay, so we punch him a little. Maybe he has a weak spine. The war house, apparently. Okay, goody. And I accidentally also punched the civilian. So we gun them down if we have to. Got it, sir. I don't think we need machine guns, it seems a little excessive. After all, we are going to abandon this car anyhow. I think it is pointing to the crusher. It's just a very convoluted way of getting there. No, it's not a kill frenzy or mission car, it's just parked that way. In GTA 1, of course, it would be a different story. Yeah, indeed, it's the crusher, right? That's what I figured. Well, they seem to be wearing lunatic uniforms. Yeah, I suppose we can maybe earn some cash in the meantime. The war house. I don't really care what this thing gives us, frankly. Yeah, a cop car. But they need to see us directly. Okay, the war house. So back the way we came essentially. And they've already forgotten about our past crimes. Isn't that nice of them? Yeah, aren't they? Okay, but it has to be this specific car, so let's not wreck it. Yeah, what type of authority do they have anyhow, right? But it's lit in dark red, kind of fitting beam. Don't look in the mirror, right? Aha. Cold blooded torture, why not? It's not our problem, so our hands are clean. As long as we don't do it ourselves. They've had port in every single district, of course, as you would think. Probably not in the police headquarters, but they're probably also going to do some torture back there. Ah, let's just see how tough you are when we bring you back to the priest invite and things like that. And this area is confusing. I'm sorry. We haven't dealt with that button so very often just yet, you know. So it's more confusing than it would have to be otherwise. So how do we access this stupid area? Okay, so that's the headquarters in here someplace. So where's the access road? And here? I guess it's where we killed that one guy in cold blood. Okay, was it mind control maybe? And of course we're crashing the car with the guy inside. I didn't see any torture or enhanced interrogation techniques or any persuasion for that matter. of course. Oh, there we go. But I think we can maybe beat the cops to that. After all, we can also crash the car for a cop bribe. we go. That's what I figured would happen. Don't make me do it, corpse. Don't make me do it. I will crush you if I have to. Well, it should work, right? Yeah, that's what I figured. I was concerned about this because, well, the pointer was still at the car. Alright, let's just see what we get out of here. It's probably just some ammo and some meaty, juicy bits there. Yeah, we can also end up as those if you ride the conveyor belt into the other area. That's just a little bit of a warning. Molotov cocktail, I guess I take it. How many though? Yeah, sometimes it's more than one pickup. I think it's a 5, you know, per pickup. Probably. Yeah, they did this. Well, isn't that nice? It's a sort of situation now, and... Oh, you, nope. Oh, there we go. Yeah, sometimes you can get stuck in geometry in this game. Thankfully, not very often. Well, I guess that will do. At least I don't remember how we can access the other area, hopefully. But it's only one road leading there, I think. This is the map edge, to the very east. I don't know how you can bounce pedestrians around in this game. Alright. So this is the main compound with the red telephone inside, I would think. Maybe not. No, it's someplace else. That's interesting. Invisibility is nice and all, but since we use up the pickups as soon as we pick them up and it only lasts for about 30 seconds, they're next to useless most of the time. For this very reason, since we cannot store them and activate them when we need them. You know, that's the problem. Okay, who's the racist now, friend? Yeah, that's the car we can use. Don't steal gang cars. Hey, how dare you? Just to demonstrate, you can do that. Click, and now we have a trader. I don't think it will be our quick getaway car. Yeah, they will chase you down and shoot you. Yeah. Alright, so this must be Benson, right? Maybe? No, it's a Vellard, so it's probably in British car. With a very long hood, so probably a V10 under the bonnet, or maybe even a V12. Wouldn't that be nice? Aha, of course you can't have that. Special loony dementia. Oh, buddy, but I don't think it would be very easy because we antagonized them pretty much. So we don't pick up any upgrades because we don't know what's involved in this mission. And these ones we have to pay out of our own pockets, which are pretty deep at the moment, but still my point stands. Yeah, okay, the Elvis impersonators. I guess it has been prepared for us, Mr. Welch. You do have connections everywhere in the city, right, don't you? Otherwise we're going to steal any. Right? I don't think a single one will suffice. Needs to be a specific type. Yeah, tread carefully in this territory now. What's it here? But it seems to be extremely twitchy, yes. Was about, you know why. In dem Fall aus Renent ist nicht so jetzt das Problem. Okay, war ein hobe das der Trick. Bombshop, yeah, there we go. Yeah, we blow the loonies to the moon, that's the idea. Now, thankfully, it's right around the corner, because we can get it repaired, right? Turning circle on this thing is atrociously bad. This thing is a joke vehicle, of course. But it's to the very north, I think. I would feel safer with a flamethrower, but of course we don't have that. Oh, this thing handles like trash. You never want to drive this, you know, actually. Okay, it's actually still here, but goody. Take a van, and now this thing is a little bit damaged. I guess you can get it repaired. Max Payne to the rescue. This has some reinforcements this time around. Just repair that fender, god damn it. Alright, it's a body armor, that's nice of your game. So, what else do we have available? The rocket launcher? I don't think so. I don't think this is a color choice available in regular traffic. I think it's only part of mission scripting. Looks pretty decent though. Guess I dig it. I think it's a darker shade than British Racing Green, yes? Oh, what's that? Yeah. I don't think it would last during our confrontation, because why would it do? Maybe 30 seconds at most. Oh, maybe, we hope for the best. Yeah, they are crazy, we know that from experience. The vent isn't super sturdy, you know. This is full throttle. And it's already expired, of course. Okay, yeah, goody. Okay. Well, maybe next time around I shouldn't bump right into the opposition der Wald. Okay, goody. And of course, they all have machine guns all of a sudden, except for the regular dudes having pistols. Oh, so we're down to 2 lives now. Well, the problem is, of course, I had to move at full speed because I can't do any scouting if people are shooting at BM. I guess you can try it again. That was kind of embarrassing, wasn't it? But next time around, we're hopefully better prepared. Yeah, okay, good idea. So, that's the problem with the reputation again. Still can't believe that happened, but then again, sometimes we do struggle a little bit, especially if I don't remember the mission objectives. But 2 lives, that may not be enough to actually complete the chapter if you aren't careful. So that's the thing to consider there. Yeah, okay, well, the flamethrower would be swell. I'm not sure there's one around these parts. The rocket launcher, once again, it's the wrong weapon for the job. But the machine gun just doesn't have the punch, you know, that's the problem. For 2 or 3 assailants, maybe, but not an entire group with machine guns. Even with body armor, you saw that, they should throw that stuff like in no time whatsoever. But flamethrowers aren't exactly commonplace around here. But that's the thing. Yeah, okay, they're only giving us the basics. In the first GTA, it was the pistol. In this game, it's the machine gun, because everyone is much better armed. Since they did improve the shooting mechanics. So they take this into consideration when designing these missions, even the supposedly easier ones.
Machine armor.
But we need guns, no tokens. But I suppose since we're here, we can try the Kill Frenzy. If it fails, we have to get a spray paint job pretty quickly. But I think they want us to blow up some cars from up here, right? Yeah. Okay, 5 people. Should be easy. Well, it should be easy, I said, and then I miss every single Molotov. There we go, there's one down.
We've got the 1034 in central Babylon.
Yeah, I think they despawn, right? Yeah, that's a problem. So maybe it's not so easy after all. There we go, 2 to go. Can we make it happen? Pretty please. At least they gave us unlimited ordnance, essentially. Well, we hit something. There we go. Doesn't qualify though, right? Oh. Oh. Well, I was hoping to kill the cops there, but apparently didn't count. Well, the problem was that most of the pedestrians did despawn off screen, you know, before I was able to get a bullet off on top of them. But not so easy after all, right? Despite the nice preparation. But of course, it doesn't bode so well for our next endeavors here. And we still shot the flamethrower. I think that BD would be the weapon of choice for the current situation. But if we don't find one, we have to make do with the car bomb angle, I guess. I mean they don't care about our compadres, right? They are expendable, I think. Yeah, I think they're 100% expendable, so if they die, they don't care. They only care about the dudes we have to kill. I think that's a flamethrower actually. No. Yeah, there's our flamethrower. 25 bursts or whatever. Should be good enough. If they run over pedestrians, no one cares. Of course. Position is required, evidently. I do like the color scheme. I guess we just use the flamethrower, but don't drive into the compound directly. We don't want to make the same mistake again, do we now? What's up here? Silenced machine gun. It's still a machine gun, but it does deal less damage even, so that's what we want. If we fry our own people, I don't think they would care, but who knows? Yeah, I think at the telephones, they only give us the machine gun, body armor and health. Nothing else. Yeah, having a smoke break is our idle animation. I guess we could run over some Yakuzas to make it easier, but it was to blast us, you know. And chaotic traffic as customary. Yeah, okay, burned, they said, and we have the flamethrower, so I guess we try that. I still believe the car bomb would be of an asset, but I don't think we're going to bother with that. They're in here, right, aren't they? Okay, goody. Wow, I'm not quite sure how close we have to be for this. Oh, really? Again? It was the one guy with the machine gun I was unable to kill in time, right? I think that happened here again. Well, fantastic. So, this game certainly isn't easy, is it now? At least with some of these missions. So, I guess then we try the other yellow mission from the telephone. Wow, I'm not quite sure why I'm struggling so much with this mission. I'm sorry, but this is kind of embarrassing. Okay, in this case, we should probably save the game here brief. Otherwise, we're going to lose all of our progress since there are limited lives in this title. And I guess we're going to try maybe the occasional... Yeah, kill Frenzy, just to get an extra life or two along the way. I mean, I prepared myself as well as I could with the flamethrower, which was a limited pickup, I think, and we still came up empty-handed. I think the bomb would have been a good idea. Okay, well, we have saved the game. We didn't lose a single multiplier, which is something, I guess. I mean, there is a kill frenzy, these two around here. We know that, but only one life remains. But I think they give us a extra life if we succeed with a kill frenzy, I believe. So there's that. Okay, some sort of police headquarters, I'm sure it will be important. Yeah, I don't think there will be a second flamethrower to be picked up there around the church. I think it was a one-time commodity. Oh, we can try the car bomb, but then again, I have to extract myself from this territory. But the regular dudes only have pistols, no machine guns, so that could be an asset. You just have to survive the other dudes, of course. Yeah, that only the car bomb angle essentially, does it not? Any pickups around these parts, maybe? But once again, these pickups are next to useless because they only last for 40 seconds. You can't activate them on demand. That's the problem. Yeah, we get data bombs and also people shooting us all the time. Yeah, so the machine guns will be useless, I think. The car bomb, if you trigger it properly, then it could work. Yeah, trigger that thing, hope it blows up all the dudes and run like a maniac. And the other guys are expendable. Maybe that could work. If you fail, then I'm not quite sure. You're going to die again, presumably. That seems to be the most likely outcome. But sometimes you just get plain unlucky in this game. It's also the nature of the situation. Not everything is under your control. Yeah, so once again, no pickups anywhere, so... Oh, it's back to the basics then, I guess. Yeah, another item that doesn't really do anything for us. I mean, it's not like I'm not looking around, I just don't see anything. Yeah, that's why I picked up the drugs. I just think our reputation with the lunatics wouldn't really make a massive difference, I think, because about these ambition-relevant characters. They would still shoot us, of course. Yeah, now the cars have despawned because we ventured too far away, I guess. Okay, well, we don't have to complete this particular telephone, but I would like to complete the mission regardless. And still two more missions from the other one, of course, and two red ones. So we still have 6 missions to go, essentially. I did create this one. But body armor in this game is next to useless, as you can tell. If we have to fight some people with machine guns. And the support is also not super helpful. At least not really right, if we're honest with ourselves, okay. Oh, then we take a detour into some sort of shop here and install some bombs, maybe some machine guns. I don't think it will be super useful, but okay. The van is not a very good vehicle, just flat out. So talking about the penis of your soul, sir, I see. Yeah, whatever. I don't think Gandhi had anything to do with that. Yeah, not even the Veggies radio station in this chapter here. Yeah, I know we can get more machine gun ammo from the hospital, but we already have that. Pickups are available from every single telephone. For the entirety of the chapter, they don't go away, unlike our one-time pickups, of course. Yeah, there we go, see, there is some health. Which doesn't matter against guys with machine guns, which is the most basic firearm beat by the enemies, really. The pistol is just for breaking rights, I guess. Okay, wow, gut eben. So, wir können try to put a bomb in here. So, das type of resort. If it doesn't work, then we have to load from our safe game and try the other missions, I guess. If we stumble upon a kill frenzy, then we have to, yeah, I think succeed with that and gain an extra life, maybe. But the vent is just a terrible vehicle, ultimately. But the bomb is the only thing I can think of, really. Okay, wow, well, then we find the next bomb shop here someplace. Probably the one where we came from. Okay, I see body armor at this hotel, but else is in store for us. I would really like to have the flamethrower. But it's only body armor. Okay, goodie. Yeah, I think we may have depleted all the flamethrower pickups already. The other one is in the compound. Of course, you can get to it, because the guys will already be blasting. If you get too close, to unload our useless idiots back there, the cannon fodder. Of course, we're also heavily outnumbered, because why wouldn't we? Yes, I think the outnumber also 2-to-1, right? Something like that. Okay, use inertia, get this vent in there, the other guys can shoot at the goddamn idiots or cannon fodder, maybe it could work. I'm trying to map this out in my head, because without the flamethrower it's not going to be easy, and forget about molotovs and things of that nature. It's going to be next to useless. I'm sure this is at least the one car we could crash to get some flamethrower ammo, maybe. But I would know without looking up a warform, which I'm not very inclined to do at the moment. I just want to find that spray job. Okay, wow, first things first, I get this thing repaired. Excellent, and then we install a bomb in here. Mm-hmm, 5000 is surprisingly affordable, and now we try our hand with that again. Hope it takes out the dudes, because I have not found a single other flamethrower upgrade anywhere. And the other firearms, like rocket launchers and molotovs, they're not going to be suitable for the current situation, although... Of course, the lunatic guards will still shoot us, so standing there to launch the molotovs over the ball, there's going to be no show. So if this doesn't work, then we have to reload and try the other mission, I guess. Yeah, I don't care about tokens. I care about flamethrowers, which are apparently already used up. I guess the game will probably put us into the safe fire, one might think. Anything back here by chance? We haven't been here before. Well, token, yes. Okay, Kill Frenzy. Hm. Maybe if we need an extra life very desperately, which we may eventually. Yeah, but some of the missions, even in the first chapter, aren't super easy, as you can tell. Hopefully they don't mind a different paint job, but I really shouldn't, right? So, 3 dudes, and they have 2 dudes. That's all we're going to get around here, I guess. Yeah, disgusting, right? So I'm not quite sure if we can approach the situation any other fashion. It's only one way to go. There's the flamethrower, for instance. Okay, could he? Yeah, there we go, finally. Keep jumping, because if we keep jumping, they can't hit us. And get ourselves an exit vehicle, thank you very much. Okay, so there we go, the car bomb worked like a charm. Of course, they don't give us any extra lives for our trouble. Oh, there's a body armor around these parts. We can try to kill Frenzy if we wanted to. Yeah, we can still get those right, indeed we can. Alrighty then, so finally we did our mission. Almost feels like a good idea to save the game again, because we're down to our last life. Oh, but sunny side, yes. Well, I guess we do that. We have plenty of money after all. So, 6 missions remaining essentially, but that video would an extra life, so I guess we try the Hero Frenzy first, just as a measure of good practice. That's another Kill Frenzy. Okay, goodie. So, right north from the church. That should be easy to remember. Even from Microbrain. Yeah, of course, it would carry a machine gun. Yeah, your little friend. I think it's playing, even when you're not in the car, like a real radio station. I'm not sure how long these are. I think they're about, I don't remember, I think they're about 8 minutes in the original Grand Theft Auto, but of course this was dictated by the space available on the CD-ROM, because it was CD audio, not compressed audio. Okay, good aim. So let's just see what you can do here with the Kill Frenzy. The 40 people. It includes the cops, I would presume, yes. Machine gun is probably the most underwhelming weapon in this game, ultimately, all things considered. Only people count, right? I think. The cars. Yeah, we need multiple impacts actually to kill someone, I think. At least it sounds beefy. Okay, and 9 more to go. And I think it's actually another Kill Frenzy over here. This one involves the flamethrower, I believe. Yeah, also against people. Of course, this is sort of based on RNG, yeah, the pedestrian spawn rate, not anything else, and there we go. So finally with an extra life, that's fantastic. And another Kill Frenzy, why not? This is the ideal area for this anyway. Of course, I can do this. It's a pretty gnarly way to kill people in this game in particular. It's always an insta-kill, especially when used against the player. Just like in the original Grand Theft Auto. But back in the day, it was usually about getting hit by exploding cars and then being lit on fire. Yeah, we also have some skeletons. I forgot that. Yeah, Kill Frenzies give you extra lives, I think, primarily, in this game. Unfortunately, they don't give us the weapons, you know, it's only infinite ammo for the duration of the Kill Frenzy. And surprisingly, a little police response. I find that kind of unsettling too. But then again, human lives are cheap in this game. This universe in general. Looks easy on paper, but once again, it isn't really all that easy. Of course, you have to wait until they burn to crisp, otherwise it's so good to do it. I don't think that's going to work, right? No, of course not. Goodie. Oh, fantastic. Well, at least you got one free life out of the deal. Yeah, so it was down to 2 seconds essentially. Well, that's what I meant with the pedestrian spawn rate. Of course, the cops are now angry because we're also a cop killer. But that's something we didn't need ultimately at the moment. Oh, then at least they have one extra dive. No, it's a pickup. Rather use this one at that. Yeah. Man in Bloom, like the one we just killed, right? Essentially. Okay, just have a clean slate. We save again because money is plentiful. Life's not so much. So, two missions from the yellow telephones and two from the red one. I think one actually does involve the police station we saw, but we have severely depleted the entire sector of available pickups. So it's mostly town to the machine gun and body armor. And that's all we're going to get. Who's the asshole now? I'm certainly behaving like one. Then again, Cloud has, well, only money on his mind, nothing else. But maybe we don't quite know how he takes. He's a silent protagonist after all. But certainly seems to be willing to do any job, no matter how gnarly. Like an unhinged psychopath. Biddy? They've been to complete this mission already. What's the problem now? Third World Bank Van. Okay, interesting. Hunty is on the move, so we need a faster ride. Sorry, sir. Please move. Yeah, armed people don't respond to your horn. At least this part of pedestrian traffic, I think. I guess they wouldn't really care if we were to run over one or two of these guys. Our reputation is after all maxed out. Hiding in this game sometimes is just hilarious. Also the physics effects involved. Okay, but the bank van is many things, but fast it ain't. Is it's armored. And it's a civilian vehicle, so we can spray paint it if we wanted to, or needed to for that matter. Okay, that thing. Yeah, and now we have the pigs again. Yeah, ah, that will do that right. Haha, the bank band of course is very, very slow to accelerate. If you want to steal this in front of the cops. But I guess getting busted is better than getting killed, because we only have two lives remaining. Man, these fucking pigs here. Stupid pigs, man. Of course, these are bunch of friends, we actually shoot at them. So that's good. Okay, so what's the rest of the mission? Okay. For fuck's sake. Yeah, shoot the goddamn cops, please. Keep them busy, at least. Exactly according to plan. That should keep them busy for a while. So what's the second portion of the mission, friends? Oh, for fuck's sake. fuck's sake, you cannot be serious with that. Oh, if they get run over by the cops, then we have a problem. They may have done this already, actually. I'm so sure about that. Sometimes regular traffic and mission scripting does not work together very well. So the cops can be annoying, certainly. Let's just wait for the heat to cool down a tiny bit, shall we not? Oh, for fuck's sake. Oh, I've had enough of these idiots. I've had enough of these fucking pigs, these swines. Yeah, the turning circle on this thing is absolutely atrocious. There we go. Also buffer the bullet holes. Although I don't think I can actually pierce our armor on this thing. With the 9mm. Okay, it's only one guy remaining, of course. Hopefully we won't need the second one. So once again the other guy is dead and the other guy almost died courtesy of a traffic accident. Isn't that lovely? Yeah, so much is up to RNG in this game sometimes. It's a little bit discouraging almost. Your failures aren't always your own fault. Yeah, am I right indeed? Yeah, be careful with it. Well, it's almost pristine. Except for a little bit of a blood splatter there on the radiator. It just adds to the charm, right? Makes a little bit of a statement. We stop for nobody with our money delivery. Yeah, hopefully the second guy wasn't essential. Of course, the cops are responsible for his demise. Once again, I think we didn't have any control over. Yeah, oh, turning circle on this thing. We can't even make a regular turn here in this 90 degree bend in the road. Yeah, this is the hospital. You may have noticed the split windscreen on most cars in this universe. Like from the 1950s. Even though back then it was already falling out of favor. Alright, are we backing in there? Probably yes. Since you can see why, that could be a good idea. Although it's probably considered suspicious, I might think. Have a nice day indeed. Fast, yeah, so this thing, nothing's going to happen very fast indeed. At least it's on the four-star bonding level, we haven't killed anyone. Well, directly. We're just dropping some third world countries off their savings. Essentially, right? Of course, it's in the compound. Oh, great. At least no coppers to interfere this time around. And now we are in safe territory anyhow. They wouldn't dare to interfere with us in here, right? Surely. And a turning circle on this thing. If it wasn't armored, I wouldn't drive it at all. Apparently it needs to be cleaned, no? If you know what I mean. Okay, makes sense. On the laundering. Of course in this game they actually don't even tell us the districts. We're supposed to just follow the arrow without the map. I if you were to look back to GTA 1, they told us the location of every single objective, of the district and everything. That was handy, wasn't it? Yeah, what was he called again? Rollo Tomasi is probably tongue sheet for something, as with many things in this game. Of course, it's in the compound, where else would he be? But why don't you tell us that, huh? Yeah. Okay, I think we should probably get a better car for this. Just in case something goes wrong. Because it could be a dirty bribe for dirty cops. And eventually even the cops will get fed up by Zabatsu shenanigans. Most likely. So let's just see where we are going exactly in here, right? Well, I told you. So we're talking to this individual then, the dirty cop. Of course it will be. Yeah, it's a good thing with an armored car. Maybe some guns would be good too. At the moment with other concerns. This car, of course, you cannot spray paint. So yeah, right. Is it in here? No, I don't think so. Right. Okay, get going. Come on, come on, come on. Almost. Oh, right. The cops do get crazy on your ass, especially on 4-star body levels and above. Okay, this safe house apparently. Okay, good here. Oh, this thing is pretty maneuverable. No! Fuck's sake! I knew this was going to happen. Oh, for fuck's sake. I knew this was going to happen. Of course they pushed us into the fucking wall. Of course they would. And then I cannot get into the fucking garage. War unbelievable. For fuck's sake, man. For goddamn fuck's sake. So close and yet so far, right? As the thing goes once again. But I'm going to bother with the Yakuza again. And just get whatever here and see what we can do. Unbelievable. Fuck bullshit. So much is up to random chance in this game with videos. Of course, we always fare the very last portion of the mission, always the very last portion of the mission, right? Of course we do, you may have noticed the trend. Okay, goodie. Wow, I do have a fast car, I have some machine guns in case it's necessary, otherwise I'm not sure what else I can do except hope for the best. Evidently, I'm not trying to fail the missions on purpose, yes? Since they have a SWAT cars on our ass immediately, essentially. Okay, get the taxi cab on here, please. And then run like a maniac. But the fate is yet again. And the car we can keep using for the next mission, I believe. At least I hope so. Other probably not. Yeah, okay, goody, there we have it. Excellent. Of course, the very last phase of the mission once more. Oh, that was money was spent, I guess. There we have it. Fantastic. Okay, so we have a couple more missions as it turns out. Maybe not. Because I only see the red arrow now. That's interesting. Okay, goody. But before we head over there, let's just save the game again, just as a matter of precaution, because we've been playing this for quite a long time, this recording session. Yeah, just to be on the safe side, I guess it's fine. I guess it's fine, yes. Yeah, okay, let's just see about the red telephone stand, shall we not? And Tau Difficult will dies Mission spielen. Oh, it's actually right here. How convenient. Okay, well, it's all upstairs and there's no handrail, so there's probably at least a one-type mission back there, I would think. That seems likely. That's a very long way to get to the telephones. But Mr. Welch is usually a pretty demanding quest giver, I think. So is there anything else around within the area? Anything else worth grabbing? Or maybe... Yeah, it doesn't look like there's much else around here, right? So let's just see what's in store for us. Oh, hobby for squeals, and there's a time pressure involved. Okay, unfortunately, they don't give us a rocket launcher. So, that's a problem. I guess a car bomb could be an option. That's a quick way to deal with things. 5 minutes doesn't seem to be super generous, ultimately. Of course, that would require us to memorize these bomb shops, right? Yeah, the machine gun is pathetic against these. Oh, okay, can I make it happen? That's what I thought, so we have to use a car bomb for this. Of course, I don't remember all of them, but there we have it. Get ourselves a bomb, please. Of course, if we miss, then we have a problem, because it's a 5-second timer on that, and these people don't stop for anything. Only traffic lights. So we cannot really box them in very reliably. The rocket launcher would be another option if we had one. And they move pretty rapidly, as you can tell. They don't stop for anything. Not sure we can afford to stop for anything either, so... Yeah, wait for the traffic light to turn on them, and then we trigger the bomb, maybe. Oh, doesn't look like it's possible, but of course the cops are on our ass. Hopefully it would work, yes. Okay, trigger the bomb, come on. There we go. That is exactly the car we were looking for. Yeah, and now we have two cop cars on our ass, and we are in a truck, essentially. Not exactly ideal. But thankfully we can solve the problem with the help of Max Payne. Yeah, let's see, they want to box us into this again. Then they love to do this. I really hate the turning circle on that thing. There we go, but of course we need a faster ride than this. I don't think the truck would do it for us. Anything faster around here, the clock is ticking down after all, anything really, that isn't a cop car. Either we could use one of those, I guess. But now it's too late. Maybe the B-Type. As said, maybe the B-Type. There we have it, excellent. Sorry, driver, we need this for something else. Of course, if we miss our car bomb, we have to try again. They give us plenty of time at least in a very first chapter, so that's nice. Yeah, we need to wait for the traffic light to change to red, and then they stop hopefully. Okay, this should do it, I hope. Well, excellent. Okay, so one more mission to go, I believe. Indeed, there was some time pressure involved, I didn't forget about that. Ah, it has been 3.5 years since I last played the game. Guess my brain has a tendency to just remember these useless snippets of information. It's like a curse we name on anything else. die eine Car heißt, die spawned again, unfortunately. Okay, dann. Last mission, presumably. And then we've officially completed all of them in a very first chapter. Ja, die Point Requirements wäre 1 Million weit und wir haben almost 9 Million once we completed our mission. But we did use most of the resources available on the map in our endeavors. Na, da Bankman heißt, okay. Okay, so we're tailing someone, they make their pickup and then we steer the van. I think that's the idea. Okay, well, stealth isn't really a massive thing in this game. Oops, sorry. So, I think that's how it's supposed to work. Thanks for that, you idiot. But really, sometimes I shouldn't cut these corners, right? Okay, tail the van, wait until he makes the pickup and then jack it. Got it, sir. Doesn't sound so difficult, does it now? But of course, it's a red mission, so it's going to be super easy. At least our Japanese friends are still friendly with us for now. So that's one less complication we have to worry about. Yeah, don't be seen, they said. There was a bank van, but not the bank van. Jerk off. I just knew this was going to happen. It's unbelievable. Stealing cars is not as easy any longer in this game, as you can tell evidently. Now we're trying to catch up in a goddamn truck. And the only stop for traffic lights, nothing else, the only stop for traffic lights. Give me that thing. Oh yeah, of course they are. Oh, would be slow if you had some machine guns on that thing now, wouldn't you believe? Okay, hopefully the safe house isn't too far away, because they have absolutely hunters down. And this thing turns terribly. They even stole a civilian car to chase us. How funny is that? And a cabine roller. I guess, well, doesn't have any trouble keeping up with the bank van. Another one, hello there. I think it's the same one, right? I'm not sure how they operate in terms of the chase mechanics. So, is it the safe house in the compound, or is it someplace else? Doesn't quite make it clear. At least we seem to have lost the two tails of ours, despite driving a bank van. Okay, so it is here indeed. Okay, goodie. What the hell, rocket launcher door? I think they blew themselves up, didn't they? Well, that's delightful. Hey man, I guess the other guy just perished someplace. Could it be? I guess in this case we don't have some machine guns, just in case. So we have this followed by vehicle and not on foot. That sounds like a smart idea. Otherwise, we keep the rocket launcher ready. Yeah, I guess the third assassin must have died someplace, even though I didn't run him over myself. I'm not sure who was responsible for that. No idea, but someone evidently was. I mean, where's the next shop here, pretty please? If only we had a paper map, you know? Okay, but I think we are as prepared as we can be, so now we need to see what's going on back there. Are they in a car? Are they on foot? If they have a rocket launched again, then, well, it'll be difficult. So, okay, they're on foot. So it's still two assassins. They just lost the track of us somehow. Isn't that interesting? Okay, got one. The other one got in the car. No, it wasn't him. We just shot some cops accidentally. I guess it also works in my eyes. Yeah, okay. Well, that's interesting. Hehehe, but I don't want to blow myself up, of course. There we go. Thank you. Ho, 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 ho. Well, that's the final job, apparently. Biddy. There's still an assassin on our ass. Offense. I'm not sure what you're talking about, sir. Oh, we have a rocket launcher, right? No? What happened here? Oh, but interesting. There we go. Good night, sweet prince. Was that Mr. Virgil coming after us personally? I thought it was pretty funny. And the rocket launcher was right on target, which most assuredly not a guarantee. Okay, excellent. Right, I think putting some weapons on that thing, it turned out to be a worthwhile idea, wouldn't you think? Yeah, that was pretty decent. Also, there's that. Let's just take our progress here and leave. Yeah, 7 jobs each, I believe. Indeed. Excellent. I think it's all in a day's work for Cloud Speed here. Well then, it's not quite the retirement funds, but we can at least proceed to the next district now. Certainly a busy day though for us. Oh, there we have it. We stole 65 vehicles. We murdered about 250 people. Not including the gang members. And I'm not quite sure what the factor means. Probably is some sort of high score, I would figure. But I think it's all we can do for this episode. So once again, I thank you very much for watching. And I hope to see you next time.